Hi, I'm Greg Smith, owner of Tomahawk Live Trap. I want to demonstrate today how to adjust a Tomahawk Live Trap for a heavy or light trigger set. So if you want a light set, a lighter weight animal will set off the trap. If you want a heavy set, it's going to take a little bit more weight for that trap to be set. Before I start, I want to point out that with every trap, when you purchase a trap, we send along the trap setting instructions pamphlet, and in this pamphlet it describes in detail with photos on how to adjust that trap. So you might want to refer to that, but we're going to go over this in the video today. In order to adjust for heavier light set, you're going to be adjusting the trigger mechanism. The trigger mechanism is in the upper right hand corner of your trap for most traps. It connects the trigger rod to the pan, and when the animal steps on a set trap, it pulls away from the door drops, and I'll just demonstrate how that works. This trap is now set, the animal steps on it. Here's the trigger that we're going to be adjusting, and there are a couple of parts to the trigger. This is called the trigger loop, and this is the trigger hook. The loop is just like it describes, it's a loop that the trigger rod is attached to, and that's what you actually use to set your trap. You pull that forward. The hook part is the part that the door rests on. So if we want to make a lighter set, what we do is this hook is shaped like an L. Here's a larger example of this same trigger, only on a larger trap. It's shaped like an L. Your door rests on the base of the L. So in order to make it a lighter set, you want to open that up so that your L actually opens up like that. If you want to make it a heavier set, you have to increase or decrease the angle and go like that. So the easiest way to do that, so take a pair of pliers or a vice grip, grab your trigger at the base. So if we do it on this trigger for this size trap, the base of your L is right there. Grab it there and then push in. So I'm going to do that on this trap. I've got it at the base of that L. I'm going to push in on that so I increase that angle. Now that'll make it so it's more difficult to set off that trap. It's going to take a little bit more weight. So I got to push on that significantly harder. Now if I want to bring that back and make it a lighter set, I'll grab that base and open it up like that. To do that, I grab the base and pull it out toward me. Now I'm going to exaggerate this a bit and pull it out so much that the weight of the door will actually set off the trap, just to demonstrate. So I try to set the trigger won't even hold that door open or up because I've opened it up so much. So I'm going to adjust it by pushing it in, so I get more of a true L shape. And now it's set. Now what you can do is open the back door and experiment with various weights to decide how you want to set this trap for the target animal that you're going for. But again, if you want to adjust this for heavier light set, it's just a function of increasing or decreasing the angle of this L, this hook. And that's just grab it with the pliers, push in to increase the angle, or to decrease the angle and make it a heavier set, pull out to open it up and make it an easier set. Okay, the next thing that we get asked a lot is the pan height. A lot of folks like to have low pan height profile. Some of them prefer a higher pan height profile. You can also adjust that. You'll need a couple of pair of pliers in order to do it. And I'll just describe what you're going to do on this bigger trigger again. So what you need to do if you want a lower pan profile is decrease the movement of this trigger mechanism. So what you have to do is move the trigger hook forward and pull the hoop back toward you, the hoop here. So if I demonstrate it on this actual trap, I want to make a very low profile. I'm going to grab the hook and the hoop and actually close the angle. So I put the hook toward me and the hoop away from me. So now there'll be less movement for that pan. So you can see it pretty low profile. Now if I want to increase that and make it a high profile, I'm actually going to open that up and push the hook away and bring the hoop toward me. So it's going to be a further distance from the two. So I'm grabbing the hook and the hoop, pushing the hook back, pulling the hoop forward, and open that up. So the pan's going to sit significantly higher. And you can see it's quite a bit higher than what it was moments ago when I adjusted it the other way. So you can adjust it to whatever preference you have. We adjust them all to about 1 inch height. And that's about where that's at right now.